Netfish and Chill TV. Today I have an unboxing for you guys. I ordered a lot of cool stuff here. Gonna explain why I got some of this stuff, what it's useful for, that kind of stuff. So, without further ado, let's get started. So here I got my handy dandy SOG seal pup knife. This is what I'm using to do my unboxing. I had this bad boy for like 3 or 4 years now. It cuts through just about anything. As you can see, it's got a little bit of wear and tear on it, but for as old as it is, it holds up really well, so let's do it. Got him! So now, to open this bad boy up, I'll thank y'all already for this. That won't break me. As you guys can see, I've got a lot of stuff here. Lots of goodies. A lot of essential stuff. I didn't just go out and spend the money on absolutely useless stuff for no apparent reason. I actually got stuff that I actually really needed. I was out of, lost. So yeah, let's get started. Alright, well, to start off, I got with me right here is a Plano Pro Latch Stowaway. This is a 3700 series box. This is just a tackle box. This is the size that I use. They fit in my actual tackle box and my backpack that I use. And I have two, the reason why I have two separate things, I have a tackle box, so if I'm going to like a really small pond, or I need to transport my stuff, I'll take my tackle box with me. And I have a backpack because a lot of the spots that I go to, you have to walk really far to. And I don't feel like carrying a tackle box that's like 500 million pounds. And it kills your arms, and by the time you get there, you know, you get a big fish, you're not going to have the endurance you did before. So that's the reason why I have a backpack. But I got three of these bad boys. It's all the same size. The reason why I got these Planos is because I've always used Plano, and that's what came in my box that I got. So I've never really had any problems with them. I thought they're really great boxes. They do not keep water out. They're not waterproof. So I wouldn't recommend this for terminal tackle, because I did use one of these for terminal tackle, and all of my stuff was just completely rusted. I had to throw away a whole bunch of hooks, a whole bunch of jig heads, a whole bunch of shaky heads, a wobble heads, all sorts of other stuff. And I wasn't too happy about that. That was a lot of money I had to throw away. So that's the reason why I got what I have next. So up next, I have a Flambeau waterproof 3700 size tackle box. Now, the reason why I got this is because I previously mentioned these are not waterproof, and they do not keep the water out completely. Whereas this is waterproof. It's got like airtight sealing, I guess is the best way to put it. Watertight sealing. You can see it. It's got like a blue lining right there. And that keeps the water out, it keeps your stuff dry, it keeps, you know, your stuff from getting rusted. So that's why I got this, because I heard really good reviews about these, but I'd never used them. Now I know why everyone uses them for the terminal tackle. Like I said, I threw away a bunch of money for the fact that I didn't have one of these. So, if you guys are having trouble throwing, like, if you're throwing away countless hooks, baits because your hooks are rusted on them, get one of these. I know John, not John Cena, John B. uses these. I think these are actually all he uses. I think his last video he actually talks about these. And he recommends them. He says they're really good, that he doesn't have any problems with them. So that's why I went and picked this up, because he says they're great. And I believe him, because he's an awesome dude. So while on the subject of terminal tackle, I picked up a whole bunch of Gamagatsu offset worm hooks, and these are the 4-ounce size. I absolutely love Gamagatsu hooks. They're probably, in my opinion, the best on the market. I think that they don't rust as much as other hooks do. I think I have a better hookup ratio with these. These don't bend, I can promise you that. Because I have had hooks where they will bend, I'll lose a big fish, I'll have a rage monster, and it's no good. You want a hook that you can trust, and I trust these. I trust Gamagatsu hooks. I pretty much only use them and VMC. Those are the only two brands of hooks that I use and trust. Like I said, you want to use something that you have confidence in, something you can trust, something you know is going to get you those fish, and I know for a fact these are going to get you the fish. So if you haven't tried these, please go out and try them. On to some more terminal tackle. I got some premium round jig heads from Lucky Strike. I like these for multiple reasons, and multiple applications. First off, it so happens that these jig heads use Gamagatsu hooks. So that had me got, like, I bought them just, like, not only for that, more or less just for that reason. So, naturally, because they're Gamagatsu, I bought them. I hadn't used them before, and now I absolutely love using jig heads because there's so many applications you can use with these. You can use them for flukes. Tubes, which is probably their most well-known application. You could use those for little crawls. Yum makes a crawl. I forget. I think it's the crawl. It's the crawl daddy. Don't take my word for that. But it literally goes perfectly with that. And it's, I absolutely love using jig heads. There's so many things that you can use these for. Again, if you haven't tried these out, use them. They are amazing. Won't miss fish. I think it's perfect for crawls though, more than anything, because you put the weight at the back of the crawl, so when you jig it up, it'll come up, and then since the weight is at the back's gonna fall, so it looks like the crawl is in the defensive position, making a more natural look, so the fish are gonna be more inclined to go get that crawl because it has a natural presentation. Next up for terminal tackle, I got some Arky U-Head. These are more or less like wobble heads, shaky heads, it's all in the same category more or less. These are good for rigging a worm. Basically, the best worm that goes with this would most definitely be a Zoom trip worm. This worm and this style hook go together like peanut butter and jelly. Now, I don't care if you don't like peanut butter and jelly, because I like peanut butter and jelly. It would go best together, so we all do. And on to some more interesting stuff, I got some cotton cordell rattle traps. These are my absolute favorite rattle traps. I do not use any other brand. These cotton cordell makes so many different colors and sizes for rattle traps. I've been using them since, actually, I started fishing. I have one that was literally one of my first lures, and I continually use it, and I still have it to this day. Haven't lost it, knock on wood. And it's a confidence bait. It's one of those confidence baits where if I'm not getting bit and I know there's a shad population, I'm going to use these because I have confidence that this is going to get me fish. So this first one I got is a bleeding white shad pattern. These are good if you have shad in a pond, specifically if they're white. Shad do come in multiple different colors and shades. So if you have maybe a pond that you know probably has some chemicals in it, and the bass are lighter and the shad are lighter, I'd say use that one because, you know, there's chemicals in there. Usually the fish are going to be weird colors. Most of the time, they're going to be lighter colors. I fished this pond that has chemicals in it. The bass are almost white, so the shad are almost white as well.
I would use this in a spot where you have a really light colored shadow. Next up, I don't really know how to describe this. The best way I'd put it is bass. Oh wait, no, it does have a label. It is bass. This would be good if, you know, you don't have any other things in your pond. If you have a pond where it's just like bass and crawls, and you're using a crawl type bait and it's not working, I'd say switch to that. Because the big bass would probably go and overpower the other bass. You know, survival of the fittest. You're the biggest pond. You can go about eating whoever you want, whenever you want. So if you have a pond that just has bass and some crawls, definitely use that because bass will always eat bass. The next one I have is Fire Tiger Wounded Shad. Fire Tiger is one of my confidence colors. Fire Tiger works literally anywhere for any type of fish that you're trying to get. You can ask anyone who fishes, they'll tell you that Fire Tiger is one of the best patterns you can use. It has that nice chartreuse belly. Certain shad do have a little bit of chartreuse on them, so that's a plus right there. The green, I guess, incorporates a bass kind of color, and I must tell you, this is by far the best pattern you can use for a hard bait. Next up, we have one of my absolute favorite baits to throw, and that would be a War Eagle spinnerbait. This is my absolute favorite spinnerbait in the whole wide world. I can promise you this will be your favorite as well. And just War Eagle brand. I have owned every single brand you can think of that is either spinnerbait, buzzbait. I cannot get fish off of anything but War Eagle baits. These are the best. I don't know what it is. If the willow blades are on steroids, the skirt is better than all the other ones, I don't know. I can't catch fish off of any other spinnerbait except the War Eagle. And that goes for buzzbaits as well. You can ask Andrew Flair, you can check out his videos, and he will tell you the best buzzbait on the market is War Eagle. And I completely agree. There's another bait I could not catch a fish off of until I used War Eagle. War Eagles are the best spinnerbait and buzzbaits on the market. Now, they're a little pricey. They run about $6 or $7, but I can promise you they are worth the money. And these also use mustad hooks. I don't know if you can see that very well or not, because the willow blade is kind of covering that. But there's another thing. It may be the mustad hooks. Mustad is another brand that makes really, really good hooks. Next, I have some Lucky Strike football jigs. Now, the reason why I picked up some football jigs is because my current football jigs are in terrible, and I do mean terrible, condition. I am filming a trick shot video. I've been using nothing but jigs, obviously, because if you guys haven't seen any of these, definitely go check out one on John B's page, Andrew Flair's page, Tyler's Real Fishing's page, and hands down, the best trick shot video you can watch is on Fluke Master's page. He is a trick shot god. You do not understand the amount of skill that that man has with a jig. Back to the jig. Sorry, I got a little distracted. I got these in a 3/8 size. This one seems to be kind of like a watermelon, kind of peanut butter and jelly kind of look to it. And then this one is black and blue. This is another confidence color. Black and blue all day long for jigs. I can promise you, if you could have one color of jig, use black and blue. Last, but certainly not least, is the SanDisk SD card. That's actually the SD card that is in the GoPro right now as it's recording, because I officially filled up my other SD card and can't film any videos without an SD card. I apologize that I couldn't film any more videos. I tried cleaning off the card, and that's a mess because I have to go through because I don't want to delete certain stuff. May need it for later videos. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope it was interesting to you guys. I love unboxings for some strange reason. Most people who have a channel hate doing unboxings, but I enjoy watching them. I don't think they're too much torture to make either, so I don't see what the biggie is on that one. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any comments or questions, please leave them in the comment box below. You can also contact me on all of my social medias at NetFishAndChillTV. Tight lines, and catch you guys on the next episode of NetFishAndChillTV.